And we're recording.
Hey, Andrew.
Oh, hey, Scott.
Welcome to March 21st.
Awesome.
Today is Monday, and it's serial killers time. Welcome to Serial Killers. It's the podcast where we talk about cereal. We'll eat it. We'll try it. We'll let you know whether you should or not. What are you doing?
I'm making this say welcome to Florida.
Why are you doing that?
Because I feel like my illustration of Florida was so good, I want to post it.
Okay.
And people will be like, actually, inappropriate looking, but accurate.
Play an open, Andrew.
All right, let's find a good one. Let's
just
find
anything.
A good one.
I know you only have like two of them in there.
You only have two of them.
Come on.
Come in.
Some boys play sports, some boys. Some boys watch sports, some boys.
No way. Special K, cause we are living in a cereal bowl.
Reviewing cereals is their goal. Scott and Andrew living in a cereal bowl. Critiquing some new ones.
And some old. What are you doodling? Stop doodling. Let's eat.
Okay. Look, I made that. Isn't that nice? Welcome to Florida.
That's a postcard.
Yeah, that's what I did.
Right. What's a postcard?
I've sent postcards, you numbskull.
You know what? I was going to quiz you and ask you how much a postcard stamp is, but I don't even know how much it is anymore.
Well,
it's probably like 38 cents or 40,
coming
maybe.
Coming to a post office near you.
You shouldn't use that word when you're showing that picture. Thank you for listening to Serial Killers. Here we are.
What?
Anyway, how you doing, pal?
I'm wonderful. This is for you for ratings.
Oh, hey, pumpkin. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I don't want to use your pen. What is this?
Those are my pens.
Where'd you steal these from?
I bought them. I actually really like them.
Fengetian. What is that?
It's Japanese.
Did you get it from Japan?
I ordered off of Amazon.
Oh, very cool.
I like them because they're so, like, I was going over this with Diamond. They have a nice consistency. They That's write nice.
Do they smear for lefties? Let's see. Five bowls. Yeah, it smears, and it's all over my hand. Now it takes me back to elementary school with a number two pencil.
Okay. What's the first cereal?
You want a new one?
Sure.
We'll start new?
Okay.
You won't like it.
All right.
I don't know. I don't know. I'm saying that, but hopefully we do like it.
Okay.
You know, I'm what's the word I'm looking for?
Gauging my interest?
No, I'm being a pessimist.
Okay.
I should be an optimist.
You should be.
The only reason I'm being a pessimist is because it says keto on it.
On the YouTube, somebody said they love my joyous mood. They like when I'm happy.
You are generally jovial.
Thank you.
And even though I come across as a giant a-hole, I'm not. I'm really not. You know that I'm a good guy, Andrew.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's all for the show.
Yeah, most definitely. So jovial.
Anyway, this is the latest in the keto line from our friends at Post, believe it or not. It doesn't say Post.
They sent this to us?
No, they didn't send it to us. I went and bought it for $7.
Oh, this is going to be bad. And I can already tell you. Look at those. Look at those aren't flakes.
Well, these are keto-friendly Incredi-Bowl Frosted Flakes. They have loops as well.
Okay.
But this is, it says frosted. I don't know what it's frosted with.
Okay.
Milk protein concentrate is the first ingredient. That's so weird. Canola oil, tapioca starch, chicory root fiber.
I wonder if this is going to become like a thing.
Allulose. For a little while,
I just don't think keto is going to be in one of those diets.
Oh, there's sugar. Sugar's way down, so it's not going to be that sweet. Is there any? Please tell me there's no stevia in here.
Oh, no.
Rosemary ester. No.
Ooh, I could taste rosemary very, very easily.
I shouldn't
easily.
Have said that. I shouldn't have said that.
You,
anyway.
Remember that one cereal that I was able to pick up rosemary on?
Yes. Well, a lot of these healthy cereals have rosemary extract in them, and they use it for... Oh, I'm sorry.
Just give me a paper cut.
Paper cut?
Yeah. I'm dying. I'm going to bleed out.
Look, I wouldn't really call these flakes, but they look nice.
I don't like when the flakes are like this.
I don't know. They look like teardrops to me. They may be a precursor of what's to happen.
Layer the teardrops on my guitar.
I just dropped the spoons.
Do you remember that song?
No.
Who? Taylor Swift. What?
Oh, yeah. Well, you sang it like a dope.
Okay, so you know the song Teardrops on My Guitar.
Absolutely. She doesn't have a twang like that. Not in that song.
Are you kidding me right now? She 100% does.
How many percent?
100. Oh, I had to call at 11. Oops, I'll bump that. You are just knocking things over left and right today.
I'm so important with my calls.
I'm going to move teardrops.
Here we go.
He's the one. Know that. Although Taylor Swift is probably going to find this episode and be like, copyright claim.
Fat-free milk from farmland dairies.
That's nice. That's great. Happy to hear that.
You ready?
Yes.
Ooh, it smells nice. It smells like cookies. Smell it. I've never heard the song. It smells like cookies, right?
It does.
It smells really nice.
She's going to say it. She's going to say it.
You got to turn it off because it's going to make me cry.
Why?
Because she has that song where she sounds just like it, and that song Never Grow Up.
Are you kidding me?
Too long. Can't play that much.
For the teardrops on my guitar.
I've heard that. Is it on my guitar?
Yeah.
So why does it say of my guitar there? Look, right there.
Well, that's the...
Right, come on, it's getting soggy.
That's the lyric version?
This smells really, really good. I'm going to tell you that right now.
Okay, one, two, three.
Andrew, this is not bad.
I got it for
you.
Hold on.
Oh, here it comes.
Sour.
Here it comes. It's not as bad as Catalina Crunch, but it's not as there. Right? That sucks.
The thing is...
I need to know why these keto cereals do that. They are good to start, but they suck at the end.
This one, I'm not going to say it's terrible.
This one's tolerable.
Like, I'd give this 3 bowls.
No, you wouldn't.
I would.
Really?
100%. How much?
How many?
100%. And I'll tell you why. I don't... The aftertaste isn't as bad. It's sour, though. I don't know where I'm getting sour. Maybe it's because I had coffee before.
No, I got it, too. It tastes like a vanilla wafer to start.
Yes.
I would give it 5 bowls to start, but if you chew it for more than, like, 5 or 10 seconds, wow, that drops.
Yeah.
I'll give it a bowl and a spoon. No, I'll give it a bowl. I'm sorry.
This is... that sour taste is really coming through, though.
Right?
I'm going to give it 2 bowls, actually. I bump it down.
It has potential. It's very good at the beginning, but then it just goes downhill. I don't know why they can't engineer a cereal to stay good when it's keto.
I think it's good that big brands are starting to get onto it, and it's not going to be as many like little brands being like, here, taste my keto cereal. Like if Post is doing it, you know, in a couple of years, it's going to taste like a normal flake. Here, but
if you were able to eat it this way and then swallow it right away, it'd be great, but you have to chew it, and as you chew it, it deteriorates.
I think this is probably one of the best keto cereals we've had, but it's not saying much, to be quite honest.
Wow. I don't know. See, if I swallow it fast enough, you don't really get that acidic 9-volt battery type of taste.
Yeah, but why does it have
that? What is that? What's a 9-volt battery?
Do you know people still use batteries?
Yeah,
every single flashlight in my parents' house, they're dead.
Not a 9-volt.
Well, all the batteries are dead. I have to
replace them.
Did
you ever do that as a kid?
What?
Take the 9-volt battery and put your tongue on it to know if it's still good?
No, I've never put my tongue to a battery.
I think you should.
I'm done with this.
But it only happens with 9 volts. You can't do it with like double A's.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, cool.
Should we move on?
Yes, please.
All right. I was shopping at the Stop and Shop the other day. I was being a traitor to ShopRite. I'm so sorry.
I forgot to bring two cereals home.
I know you did. From Publix?
No, we went to Winn-Dixie.
From Winn-Dixie.
Yeah.
It's my other favorite.
They had a snickerdoodle and a peanut butter one.
Oh, I got a peanut butter one. We'll get into that later.
Okay.
Anyway, so this one's from Stop and Shop. It could be called Giant in your town.
Oh, I can't wait for this one.
This is weird, though, because I couldn't tell exactly what it's supposed to be. First of all, it's called Be Well Vanilla Almond.
It's so condescending. Be Well.
Yeah. Be Well.
Be Well.
But the thing is, though, it's not Honey Bunches of Oats because they have a fake Honey Bunches of Oats. And this wasn't next to any of the brand name cereals, so I don't know what it's supposed to be. It's almost like it would be Special K with almonds.
Yeah.
Is that possible what this is?
I think so.
Okay, so Special K with almonds.
I'm excited for this.
I don't know what this little symbol means. It's a little guy running with a star. Like, what?
It means they're superstars.
I don't know what that means.
Let me see.
That's a big spoon on the side. Look at the side.
Woo! Is that scaled for...
Shake it up.
Oh, it's guiding stars. The more guiding stars, the more nutritional value. Guidingstars.com.
Oh, so there's nutritional value in there?
Yeah.
Okay.
What are you looking for?
I'm just going to do this. I'm going to let you do it today.
What?
Where is it? There's not even one
go
here.
Back. Yep. Next one.
No, this is just dumb. Where is it even?
It says Scotty
right
Shake.
Here?
Diabetes.
No.
It's literally the
What's book. Up, Wilford? You don't even know how to do it. That doesn't... Yeah, over. Turn it over. Yeah, that's how you do it.
All right, that is vanilla almond. Be well. Could be called a
knockoff.
What is the one that it's called in other places?
A giant.
It could be a giant where you are. Let's go into this. You ready, Andy?
You're gonna rip it. Ah, you ripped it. You don't stop. You got to slide your fingers under it, Andrew.
Do you get like panic attacks when your kids open Christmas presents?
You sure know how to stress someone out.
I don't.
Seriously.
Seriously?
You know how to stress out a cereal aficionado.
Okay. That's what you're calling yourself now?
Yeah.
Cool. That's good.
Well, I mean, you stress me out, Andrew. This box is destroyed.
It's destroyed?
Yeah, after this, it's going right in the garbage.
That's rude. People might want it.
Who?
I don't know. Oh, my God.
Are you okay?
I feel like I'm getting, like, acid reflux.
From what?
I don't know.
From the Incredi-Bowl Frosted Flakes?
Maybe. That acid taste was so weird.
What if I spilled a little bit of milk on your ring?
That would be fine because it's waterproof.
Is it milk-proof?
I don't know. It would probably smell like cheese. Ugh. I have to wash it.
You ready?
One, two, three. It
smells, yeah, it's, yeah. It smells like Frosted Flakes. Mm. Now, is that natural vanilla or artificial?
Artificial.
No, I don't think so. It says with vanilla and other natural flavors.
With vanilla flavor, it says it right there.
Right, with real almonds and vanilla flavor. But it doesn't say artificial vanilla flavor. Is there vanilla in here? Why is there no vanilla in here?
It's just flavoring.
Rice, whole grain, wheat.
From six different chemicals.
Sugar, almonds, wheat bran, soluble wheat fiber, salt, corn syrup, malted barley syrup, honey, mixed tropicals. And that's it. There's no vanilla in here? That's BS. They got vanilla beans on the front of the box.
Yeah.
Liars.
That's weird. It only got one guiding star, so.
Well, I mean, at least it has one. I didn't get any almonds. You didn't shake it very well, Andrew.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, this doesn't even have it.
Right? Isn't that weird?
Interesting. Quality guaranteed or your money back.
Well, I mean, the quality is okay. I'm going to give it two bowls and a spoon, though. It's okay, but it's not great.
Yeah, I give it three bowls. It's good. I'm a little sad, though, that it doesn't have actual vanilla.
Isn't that weird?
I don't like that.
Especially since there's two Madagascar vanilla things on there.
Madagascar vanilla?
Isn't that what it's called?
Do you go and forage for it? Is that how you knew it was that?
Yeah,
and
large. That's
just such a weird thing to say. Like, you knew it, like, right off the bat. Like, they put Madagascar vanilla on the box. That's so strange.
You're such a jerk.
I'm just saying. You're the one who, like, knew. Also, it's the same picture front and back.
It is.
They got lazy with the box art. That's all I'm going to say.
Yeah, well, all right. Sorry, giant.
Or Stop and Shop, whatever. Depending on location.
Oh my God, I'm choking on almond.
Oh, I thought you didn't get enough almond because I shook it terribly.
I got one almond in that whole thing.
What am I going to have for lunch today? I'm going to do a salad.
Why? Aren't you full from cereal? No, I eat one spoonful. You eat a whole cup, you fat bastard.
Did you really eat?
What?
Did you? But you didn't finish that one.
I didn't.
Did you finish that one?
No, but I had a couple spoonfuls. I got to test it, dude. I have to give the people what they want.
Okay.
And you know what? If they're going to rely on us to let them know what cereal to buy, we have to actually try it and eat it and taste it.
Yeah.
Not just a, ooh, I don't like it. Like you.
I almost did a secret serial killers episode without you.
You should have. What, from the road?
Yeah, when we were in the Keys.
You should have. Remember I wanted to do one when I was on the ship and you were away and you're like, no, that would never work.
Yeah, because again, the minute I get you on any type of Zoom situation and it's a little bit delayed, you'll be like,
Now,
my quality is terrible.
Okay. I have to tell you how excited I am when this box arrived.
Okay.
I came in this morning.
Should we take a commercial break first?
Yeah, why don't we do that? It doesn't work. You have to touch it. We'll be back.
We need to get a little touch screen thing.
Right after this. Stay where you are. And we're back.
Yeah.
Did it work?
Do you know I don't cut that out for the YouTube?
What?
So you literally see me count.
Really? I haven't watched a YouTube in a while.
Mm, that sucks for you.
Why? I know what we look like. I like to listen to it.
My dad actually prefers watching.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I do that too.
That's my boy.
But I do that with YouTube videos in the car too.
Yeah.
Because it's almost like listening to a long form podcast.
Okay.
I actually get my best listening done when I'm in the car with YouTube videos. I save videos for later.
I'm very excited for this box.
Who's it from?
Do you know where it came from?
Colleen.
Guess what state it came from?
Iowa.
Yes! Yes! This came from Colette.
Someone actually, I think Juan, our friend Juan, yeah. He made me a corn thing. Let me see if I have it.
Colette from Winterset, Iowa. I don't know exactly where in Iowa that is. I lived in Northwest Iowa. And
Northwest. Oh, see, I have it.
So it cost her $20 to send this package. Thank you very much, Colette. But you know what the coolest thing about this is?
Yeah.
What are you doing? What?
So Juan made this for us.
Sugar frosted flakes of corn.
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 You know where they grow corn?
Say it.
Cedar Rapids,
there
Iowa.
There it is.
Thank you so much, Juan.
Oh, Juan.
He made that.
Speaking of Iowa, check this out, Andrew. It's an entire box of cereals from Hy-Vee. My favorite Iowa supermarket.
That's great. I'm
Look
so
at that.
Happy for you.
Well, what do you want to try? I'm going to let you pick.
Can I go in blind?
No. I'm going to give you the great flavors, okay? There's apple cinnamon Tasty-O's.
Uh-huh.
Okay, those are going to be like...
Why don't we just write them down and I'll pick them out of a cup? That'll be fun.
No. I would just want you to choose it. Okay.
I want to go in blind.
It says, if you like apple cinnamon Cheerios, try this.
No.
Okay. Then there's honey nut Tasty-O's.
If you like
honey nut Cheerios, try this. And there's a happy bear on there with a jar of honey.
Is that, what's his name, the shop right there?
No. It is Scrunchie's long lost cousin. I just cut my neck open. Oh my God, I'm gushing. All right. Cocoa peanut butter spheres.
Okay.
If you like Reese's Puffs, try this.
Okay.
Okay. Peanut butter multigrain toast Tasty-O's.
That looks exactly like the Cheerios.
It is.
I'm shocked Hy-Vee has not gotten sued.
If you like multigrain peanut butter cereal Cheerios, try this.
No.
Okay. Then there's cinnamony crunch. Okay. If you like General Mills cinnamon toast crunch, try this.
Okay.
I love how they actually tell you.
It is nice.
Yeah. Honey Graham crunch. Honey Graham cereal. If you like General Mills Golden Graham cereal, try this.
Okay.
And then there's Coco Rageous with a really angry rhinoceros
on
the front.
He's happy.
Yeah, but he's angry too.
I like him.
His horn is rocking.
I'm going to call him...
Okay. If you like post Cocoa Pebbles...
That's a Triceratops.
Try this. That's not. That's a rhinoceros.
That's a Triceratops.
Oh, because he's got short arms.
It's a dinosaur.
Okay, you're
that's
right.
That's why.
You're right. You're right, Andrew. Okay, so there's that. I think I'm leaning there, but I'm going to
Cocoa Rageous?
Pick.
Yeah, I am too.
And then there's one more, Andrew. PB&J Puffs.
I want to save that one.
What's up now?
I want to save
See,
that.
This one does not say if you like blah, 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 try blah, 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 because there is no cereal like this, and I don't understand why.
We are always pleasantly surprised with these.
Why won't Big Brand Cereal make this cereal?
I know.
It is delicious.
They're getting too...
Everyone we've had has been delicious, except the one that you didn't like, which was fantastic. And I don't even remember what brand it was. I think it was Stop and Shop.
Yeah, I didn't like one.
Or the Wegmans. I think maybe you didn't like the Wegmans one.
I want Cocoa Rageous.
Let's do that.
With the Hy-Vee Triceratops.
Cocoa Rageous.
I'm going to call her Trixie. Hy-Vee Triceratops.
Thank you, Colette.
Thank you, Colette.
Yes, you brought me back to 1994 and Hy-Vee and Donut Land. Donut Land is one of my favorite donut shops in Cedar Rapids. I don't know if they're still there.
Okay.
Yeah. I actually won a dozen donuts and a six-pack of beer from a radio station while I lived out there.
Hmm.
It was great.
That's interesting.
That was a big prize.
Could you eat a whole thing of donuts by yourself? Or could you have in your heyday?
Could I have? Yes, I could have.
I could never eat 12 donuts by myself.
I mean, I'd probably feel sick after three or four, but I would truck through it.
They're so filling. Like a donut is not... Like a pizza, I could. Easily.
A donut's very heavy. Yeah. You could eat a whole pizza?
100%.
No way.
100%.
I would say maybe 75%.
Uh-uh. I know I can.
A full regular-sized large pizza from a pizza place.
I friggin' love pizza.
I'm not talking about a little like pizza.
Yep, I love pizza that
personal
much.
Personal pan pizza.
I love pizza that much.
I love it too, but I can't eat an entire one.
I think you'd be surprised with yourself.
I don't know, Andrew.
Like an artichoke one? No, because those are like...
Nobody knows what that is.
Yeah, they do, because you know they're in like all across the country now.
Okay.
I think there's one in Vegas now, too.
No one knows what that is, Andrew.
Nobody knows Las Vegas. No one's heard of Las Vegas.
Artichoke is a pizza place. It's a chain. Not really chain. They're from New York.
Uh-huh. Well, they're expanding.
Okay. Ready?
Just like our waistlines.
Very good.
Cocoa
Pebbles.
Mm.
A little different. The cocoa's a little different. It's not bad.
Yeah.
Now, I mean, they have to say it. But it says, this is a serving suggestion. So the serving suggestion is to just have a spoon with milk splashing off of it. That's how they want you to eat it.
Okay.
I don't even think we could if we tried.
Yeah, no.
That would be a mess.
We should actually try that on a bowl chat, trying to make the box art.
Yeah. Oh, this is nice. Hy-Vee One Step. A portion of this purchase helps feed the hungry.
I would like to see this.
Okay.
Who's on the back?
Some basketball guy.
Hmm. How would Trixie sound?
Hey, I'm Trixie the Triceratops. Have you had Hy-Vee's Cocoraidus?
No. That sounds like Nate trying to be, what's his name, from Family Guy. The creepy neighbor?
Oh, yeah, the old guy.
Yeah.
How do you think Trixie sounds?
I don't know. It'd be one of those dopey things like, duh, hey, guys. That one.
I do love that. Yeah. Oh, wow, you got the job. You're now the voice of Trixie.
Thanks.
Say something.
Who is that?
You have to say something. It's Trixie.
Hanson Barnes?
Tell people to come down to the Hy-Vee.
No, I forgot the voice already.
It's the dopey voice.
Hey, guys. Join me at the Hy-Vee near Westdale Mall.
I like that you just go with what you know.
Yeah.
Maybe next to Donut World.
Cocoraageous. What do you give it, Andrew?
Two bowls and a spoon.
That's it?
Yeah. Ow. God.
All right.
Ever since you made me increase the levels when you yell, it's...
I will give it three bowls and a spoon. It's not Cocoa Pebbles, but it's relatively close.
Yeah. I'm not a huge fan, but yeah. It's a...
Harrison Barnes. That's his
distributed
name.
By Hy-Vee, Inc. in West Des Moines, Iowa.
Love that.
Des Moines.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Well, this was nice.
Oh, we could totally do the word search. When you buy One Step products, you help gardens grow. I don't know. How's he doing that sideways? Oh, is that planking?
Do you know that when I was in college, one of the colleges I transferred to, I knew I had to leave when there was a crossword puzzle test. And
that's sad.
Kids failed it.
Really?
The word bank was on the board. And you know what the secret is? All you do is just look at how many letters, and then you just went off the biggest letter, and you could get everything off of just the biggest one.
Right.
And I did it in like 5 minutes, and people were like, how did you finish it so fast? Like, are you dumb? There's a giant word. Just fill it in. Go backwards.
Yeah, those are easy.
Kids failed it.
Post is a registered trademark of Post Foods, LLC. Pebbles is a registered trademark of Hanna-Barbera Productions, Inc., Hollywood City of Los Angeles, California.
Wait, Trixie is a Hanna-Barbera cartoon?
No, it's stolen.
Oh.
No, Trixie's not. They just say, because it says right here, Post Pebbles.
I like that we just also named her.
You did.
She's great.
All right.
If Hy-Vee uses this and I find out that there's a Trixie being used by Hy-Vee, guess what? Suing you.
Well, you know what, though? That thing has to have a name.
Call in corporate.
I bet all these animals have names. They're mascots.
If they were smart, they would.
That's the Cocoraageous mascot, Trixie.
That we've named.
Yes. Thank you for listening.
If you use it without our permission, we will get you.
No, we won't. Thank you for listening.
Yes, we will.
To Serial Killers. Maybe they'll sponsor us. Hy-Vee's a huge supermarket chain. Don't be mean to Hy-Vee. They can use whatever they want. I don't care. They can call that thing Andrew, and I'd be like, that's great. Pay us. Right?
That's what I'm saying. But if they steal our intellectual property of Trixie and the voice.
How do you like this, guys? This episode of Serial Killers is brought to you by Hy-Vee.
I love that. I can't do the voice as well as you.
Double coupons. Sometimes.
Okay.
Anyway, thanks for listening to Serial Killers. This has been an exciting episode, Andrew.
Has it? It was an average episode.
You know what?
But I felt we had good banter.
Yeah, there was a minute where there were so many new cereals that they just kept coming, and now it's slowing down now. I need new good sugar cereals, like new stuff. Come out with a new Lucky Charms or something. I know they have the green one for St. Patrick's Day, turns the milk green, great. Everyone's like, have you seen this? Yes, they have it every year.
We have to expand our horizons to more international cereals.
Okay.
If you see them, send them.
Yeah.
If you're in Australia and you're somehow listening to this, send them. If you're in New Zealand, send them. Japan, South Korea, China, send us those cereals.
Okay. Follow us on all social platforms.
Italy
Serial
too.
Killers PC. Grazie.
Grazie mille.
Serial Killers PC. And check out our website, serialkillerspc.com, for all the cereals that we've eaten. All, I don't know, 800 of them.
Yeah.
Right?
I have to say, I also got compliments this weekend on the website, too. At the wedding that I was at. People were like, or 2 weekends ago.
Mm-hmm.
People were like, that website you have is so nice.
Really?
Yeah.
Thanks, Scott. Other Scott.
He's great.
All right, we got to go.
They just want it to be able to filter by ratings, though.
Okay.
That's so if you typed in chocolate, you could see the highest rated chocolate ones.
God, you say crunch, Andrew. Crunch.
We didn't say the follow and like and subscribe.
I did.
Well, I'll say it now. Hurry. Go like and subscribe. Leave us a review. We love reading your reviews. And who knows? We might read your reviews on the show. Serial Killers PC on everything. And yeah, have a great day, everybody.
Say crunch, Andrew.
Crunch!
I'm sorry. I gotta catch a train.
I gotta go.
I gotta go to train.
Gotta train. Just the word train.
Goodbye.
Bye.